Hey guys, welcome to another computer graphics tutorial. Today we'll be learning about liquid crystal displays, a tutorial by QuickCS. So let's get started. First we'll learn what is liquid crystal display. A liquid crystal display or LCD is a flat panel display that uses the light modulating properties of liquid crystals. Okay, so basically LCD is a flat panel display which uses light modulating properties of liquid crystals. Liquid crystals do not emit light directly. They don't emit light. That's why LCD is a non-emissive type of display. Okay, instead it uses a backlight or reflector to produce images in color or monochrome. Basically you can produce color images also as well as monochrome, that is black and white images also. In that, monochrome can be any other singular color, or mono means single, chrome means color. Okay, LCD are available to display arbitrary images, as in your general purpose computer displays. Many computer monitors still use LCD. It's not outdated, it's still in use. Or even for that matter you have your calculators, which are fixed images, basically a low information image, that is your calculator or your digital watch. Those are low information contents. Okay, they use the same basic technology, except that arbitrary images are made up of large number of small pixels, while the other displays have large elements. Basically the small pixels are there in complex images. Okay, and in our normal digital watch or digital calculator, it is using larger elements. So what is the structure of a LCD? It's called liquid crystal display because these compounds have a crystalline arrangement molecules and still flow like a liquid. Okay, so they have a crystalline arrangement and they still flow like a liquid. Flat panel LCDs commonly use nematic means thread like liquid crystals compound that tend to keep the long axis of the rod shaped molecules aligned. Okay, basically it keeps the rod shaped molecules aligned. In LCD flat panel display, two glass plates, each containing a light polarizer at right angles to the other plate, sandwich the liquid crystal material. So basically on one side you have one glass plate, okay, which is having horizontal lines or horizontal traces, and on the other side you have another glass plate which is having, let's say, vertical lines. Okay, and in between them the liquid crystal material is sandwiched, or basically it contains the liquid crystal material, both these plates. Okay, this is the structure of the LCD. Now working of LCD. One glass plate rows of horizontal transparent conductors are built and columns of vertical conductors are put into the other plate. Okay, the intersection of two conductors define a pixel position. The intersection as in where both the lines, that is the vertical and horizontal line, meet, that is the intersection. Okay, normally the molecules are aligned in the on state. So when it is in on state, that is when the light is displayed, what happens is the molecules are in aligned state. Okay, polarized light passing through the material is twisted. Okay, it is twisted. Why is it twisted? So that it will pass through the opposite polarizer. Okay, so to make it pass through the opposite polarizer, because as you can remember, one is horizontal and another one is vertical. So whenever they are having a cross section, it has to pass through the next polarizer. That's the reason it needs to be twisted. Okay, so for that reason, when it is on state, it is twisted. To turn off the pixel, we apply voltage to the two intersecting conductors to align the molecule so that the light is not twisted. So basically when the light is not twisted, it will not pass through the other side of the polarizer, making it an off state. Okay, this type of flat panel LCDs are known as passive matrix LCDs. Okay, now advantages of LCD. LCDs are very compact, thin and light, especially in comparison with bulky heavy CRT display. CRT means cathode ray tube. If you don't know what CRT is or how CRT works, I have made a separate video on cathode ray tube. I'll put the link in the description below, you can check it out. Okay, there is low power consumption, which is another advantage. Little heat is emitted during operation due to low power consumption. Now why there is low power consumption? Because it is either using an external light source or just reflecting lights. It's not converting electrical energy into light. So that's the reason there is low power consumption. And since there is low power consumption, there is low heat. Okay, it can be made in almost any size and shape. Okay, that's one very big advantage, that you can make it in any size and shape. Okay, not like our plasma panel displays which require at least 30 inches. Okay, now what are the disadvantages? Limited viewing angle in some older or cheaper monitors. Nowadays that's not the case, but in previous models it used to happen that the viewing angle was not wide enough. Okay, uneven backlighting in some monitors. Basically, it's dependent on an external light source, of course. So the lighting can be uneven. Okay, black levels may not be as dark as required because individual liquid crystal cannot completely block all the backlight from passing through. Okay, that's one of the disadvantages, that blacks are not dark enough. Dead or stuck pixels may occur during manufacturing or after a period of use. Yeah, this is one of the major problems that happens in LCDs, that there is a dead pixel or stuck pixel. Okay, if you have a mobile phone which usually use LCD, you can just check, there might be some dead pixels, very small quantity, but yes, they exist. Even on televisions, after long time of hour, it's burnt pixel or dead pixel, they call it. Okay, so these are the disadvantages of LCDs. Okay, thank you guys for watching this video. Guys, if you like this video, please like and share this video with your friends. Please make sure that you subscribe to our channel. If you have any doubt, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Thank you very much.